Hi everyone, Chef from Outdoors in the Low Countries. Now here you see an old coffee table which is not used anymore, and instead of making firewood out of it, I decided to create a wood storage cart from this old coffee table. Now this coffee table has these drawers which are ideal for putting in small pieces of timber or other stuff. Now in order to have a mobile wood storage cart, I will use these wheels that I have lying around. The wheels will increase the height, and since I don't want to make it too high, because then only the timber put on top of that will also become higher, I will reduce the table length a little bit. The table has been lowered, wheels below, so it's now nicely mobile. So the next step is now to put on the top structure that can hold the timber. Now the first question is, how many sections do you want to have on your wood storage cart, and how do you want them to be? Now the first section I want to have quite low for smaller storage of material. The second one I want to have a little bit higher. So the typical maximum length that I will have on my wood storage cart of the timber is about this size. Because when it's much longer than this, I don't think I'll put it on the storage cart, but put it somewhere else. So the typical height of the support structure will be about 80 centimeters. And when I have these type of material for the topside support, then I need about 70 centimeters of length of the legs of the support construction at the backside. Now the wood that I will use in this project will be from a cherry tree. Here are still some rough pieces that I will now cut into the right dimensions, which I can then use for the wood storage cart. So here you see the basic principle of the wood cart. The small parts at the front, the larger part at the back. So when you're going to put wood in the storage cart, most of the weight is going to be in this direction. So that's also why I put the long side of the construction in this direction, because then it has the maximum strength. So the next step is to create five more of these, so I can have the standing poles of the wood cart ready. So we use this square combination with this double jig in order to make sure that they are at the same location every time. So for the ones in the center, I'm going to measure where the center actually is. The table is 130, so it's 65 in the middle. That's over here. Now this dowel has a 50 millimeter distance from this line towards this actual dowel line. So I will put, also remark it 60, because that's where the front should be. So when I align this with the line over here, then this will be at 65, which is exactly the middle. Now the only thing then I need to do, make sure it's the same distance that I do with my square, and now I have it. This is the right location. So the bases have been made. I will put on top some parts, in between some parts, to finish it up.
So the base of the wood cart is from an old coffee table, but all the wood that is on top of that is from a black cherry tree that I need to cut down anyway. And with the chainsaw mill together with the bandsaw and the thicknesser, I created my own wood for doing this type of lumber work. So nothing has been bought to create this storage cart, it's all sustainable materials. And here you can see the roughness of the chainsaw mill, and now with the thicknesser I'm going to make it smooth and parallel. Now with the glue clamp I created the construction as I want to have it, and in order to have the right positions of the jewels I'm going to create a center line. Center line on this one and a center line on that one. This should be the center line. So I put the tool on the center line. Now I'm going to clamp it to make sure that it doesn't shift. Now as you can see, the two outer ones are quite towards the edge. That's for me too risky, I'm not going to use them. So I'm going to use the ones. So number two and number four instead. So also here I will put the tool at the center line. Now at the bottom of the cart you need to have some construction that prevents the wood falling through. Now I don't want it to have it completely at the bottom, because then it will only collect dirt and it's not easy to clean. Now when I have a distance like this, it will still prevent the wood from falling through, but there will not be any dirt collection here, and it's also very easy to clean it with some compressed air to clean out the dirt. Now the level of this bottom part is arbitrary, but about this height is right, so that's about 130 millimeters. Now I really recommend this jig, because this is a great tool. It's very easy to place it at a certain distance. This is what I really like about this tool, because you just turn the knob and you can place it at every center line you want to have, and also easy to adjust it. There are also some other ones which you need to have special parts, and then it's still, let's say, a certain dimension. This is really something that I like. And it's a very robust tool as well, and it really helps to put the dowels in the right place without being concerned that it won't fit afterwards. Now for example, I take this beam, so I put in, okay, this is the front side, so give it an arrow towards the front, knowing that that's the place where I need to put the jig against, and also identify what is the top side. The same I do on the other side, so this is the front side, so also here, this is the front side. This is where I put my jig, and then this is the top side, so this is where I align the jig. So here you see the top marking, that means that I'm going to align it from this side. And also here you see the two arrows, which means this is the face that I will use for the jig. So the jig will be against this part to this face, and then align it at the top side, so here. So this is perfectly aligned. Then I use the clamp to make sure it won't move during the drilling, like that. And now simply drilling the first one and the fourth one, and it's ready. Doing the same on the other side. Here you see again the face mark, the top side. So the face mark means this is where I'm going to put my tool against, my jig. Aligning it here, in this case at the top side. clamping it so there's no movement. Like this, perfectly aligned. First one from top side, and then the fourth one. And we have our beam ready. Also here, so this beam has to be like this. So I thought about what the best dimensions would be from a height perspective. But this is for the smaller timber. But I could have the same height here for this beam, but then that becomes also to like a box-like of structure. And I would like to have a little bit more dynamic in the design, so I will put this beam a little bit higher, like 3 centimeters, and also this one again a little bit higher, so you get a little bit more of a stepwise construction, which gives a more dynamic design than just a simple box. So it's 13, 13, 13 below, 53 here in the middle section, and 56 at the end. So now I will take out the standing profiles one by one and use a jig in order to make the holes at the right position. So now all the parts are now lying here. They're all coated. There's a small coat over here where I can see where it has to be. So I can now put it all together like a do-it-yourself construction package, using dowels, adding some glue just to give it some extra strength, and then build the whole system up until we have our coffee table wood storage card. So I added some glue clamps in order to have some more pressure on the glue connections. So the next step is now to let the glue dry and then have a finish. So the woodcutter has now been standing here for a couple of days, so it's now time to take off the clamps. And other heavy stuff. So the first layer has been applied. It always takes a little bit longer than you think, but it has been done. Now let it dry, and then later on we do a second layer. So for the finish, I wanted to use some of the old products that I had already lying around. So I tried them on the cherry wood and see how they looked. And I started off with this one first because I thought it fitted well with a coffee table. But to be honest, it looked very nice on a very small part, but on the larger part, I thought it was not that great. So I also put on this one as a second coating. I'll put the link in the description so you see what type of finish I've used. Now the casters that I currently have mounted underneath the wood storage card have rubber tires, and they are as a result flexible. And what I already noticed is that when I had the cart full with wood in order to have enough pressure on the glue connections, that it was already giving more resistance when moving around. So I looked on the internet and I bought these ones. I will put the link in the description. These are nylon wheels. They are much less flexible, so they have much less indention on this hard ground. They can only be used on flat surfaces. But yeah, I have here a flat surface, so that's no problem. And it will give much less resistance in moving the cart around. Now this wheel can have 150 kilos, so with four of them, it's 600 kilos. So that's quite a lot to put on this storage cart. So now the first step is to remove the rubber wheels and replace them with the nylon wheels. And let's see how the resistance is then improving. wheels have been mounted. So it's now time to load it up with timber that I have lying around. So the wood storage cart has three sections. The large parts I put at the back, the medium long parts at the front, and the smaller parts you can put in the drawers below. So what are the dimensions of this wood storage cart? Well, the width is 125 centimeters. This section is 31 centimeters. Over here we have 40 centimeters. The height of the low part is 50 centimeters and 79 for the high part. The drawers have an internal width of 40 centimeters, 41 centimeters, and 62 in length. Because of the open structure, the wood storage cart is also available at the back side, and because the drawers are also available from this side, also here the wood is ready to be taken. Now, the very tall pieces I won't put on this storage cart because I will put them somewhere else. And also, when they hit the ceiling, or at least the beams of the ceiling, it's not mobile anymore, so I also don't want to put it anyway on this cart. Also, the very large boards I also won't put on this cart because I store them somewhere else. So this is really for the easy take of wood that I expect that I will use in some projects. So you see, it's quite possible to create a wood storage cart from materials you have lying around anyway and make something that is fitted to your personal needs of whatever you need in your project. If there are any more questions or comments on how I made it or why, please put them in the comment section below and I will be happy to reply to it. And I hope you enjoyed the video. Thanks for watching, and I see you next time.